In this video, I'm going to cover full-text searches. So full-text allows for more sophisticated searches, such as using multiple keywords and increasing and decreasing importance of keywords. Before, only MyISAM allowed full-text, but now both MyISAM and DinoDB allow full-text. And the one important thing to know, two actually, is that when you use full text, a word must be at least 4 characters long, and search results must be less than 50% of all records. Otherwise, it's just not gonna work. And I'm gonna be using this advanced SQL database, but I'm gonna import the users table and use that table. Okay, so to use full text, you need to specify full text indexes on the columns you want. So first name and last name, let's say I want to be searchable. So I'm gonna go to SQL and say here, alter table users, add full text on first name and last name, like so, click go. And if I now say show index from users, I see here first name and last name, they have the same key name, but that doesn't make a difference, and full text here, so it's all good. And if I go to the table users and structure, I can see these gray keys here, which means they have the full text indexes assigned to them. So to do a search, and let me open this table users in a new tab, just so I see what they have here. So a basic search, I'm gonna say select, and let's say first name and last name from users, where, and now match, and in parentheses you need to specify all the full text columns you have, so first name and last name, against, so compare against what, let's say Johnson, and I'm gonna click this retain query box here to retain this. If I click go, here I get John Johnson, which is correct. And you can also show relevance of the search terms, which isn't gonna be of much use now, but it would be maybe to you if you had more rows and a bit more sophisticated search. But anyway, I'm gonna say here select first name, last name, and then here I'm gonna say comma and match, and then repeat basically this part here. So just copy that and paste it there. So I'm gonna now get relevance for this, and if I click go now, I get the same result but with some number here for relevance, and I'm gonna get rid of that now. You can also search for multiple keywords, so let's say I want to get this Jack as well, so I'm gonna say Johnson and Jack here, and if I do a search now, let's see, I get both of them, so that works. And if I, for example, search for Johnson and Bob, let's see what happens. I just get Johnson. Why am I not getting Bob Bobson? Because Bob is a three-letter word and it's not gonna work. Okay, so they have to be at least 4 letters. And you can also have more sophisticated searches with in Boolean mode keywords. So let's say I want to search for anything that starts with John. So I'm gonna have John here and a star here, which is the wildcard basically. But then here I need to say in Boolean mode as well. So if I click go now, I get John Johnson. But if I change Jackson to Johnson and click go again, now I get both of them. And you can also use plus and minus signs with this in Boolean mode. Plus means that the word must be present, and minus means that the word must not be present. So now I get John and Jack here, but if I say here, let's say plus John and something and minus Jack, so John something must be present and Jack must not be present. So if I say go now, I just get John Johnson, I don't get Jack. There's also a milder form of this minus, which is the tilde, which basically means that the word can be there, but those matches are of lesser importance, which isn't going to make a difference now, but just so you know, it exists. So if I click go now, I still get Jack because there's not that many values to choose from or rows. And finally, there are also double quotes and less than and greater than. Double quotes are used to match a phrase, and less than and greater than to decrease and increase a word's importance. So I'm just gonna have some arbitrary query here. I can say, for example, select subject and message from forum table, where match, and in here subject and message against, and in here now inside of single quotes and in boolean mode, I can search for a phrase, so double quotes here, for example, hello there, and I can also add greater than before this double quotes, and for example, plus PHP. So this is gonna look for the phrase hello there, and PHP word must be in there as well. And the emphasis in the search results is gonna be on the hello there phrase because of this greater than. And there's also less than, which means that this isn't so important. Okay, that's it for this video. See you in the next one.